very, very, very impressed. Organization is on the top. It's the flair is awesome. The connections are very good. Did a lot of talks with students, connecting, engaging them. Yeah, very impressed. I quit university very early because I taught myself everything via YouTube and the internet. So I'm teaching over 1 million students every month. I do that with over 2,000 videos on YouTube, mathematics videos. I'm running a learning platform where I'm combining videos with tasks and tests. And 3 years ago, I co-founded a startup where we organize offline crash courses, 3 days to pass exams. We are now at a point where we have 800 courses in Germany and Austria. And this year we opened stores, offline stores, where we offer learn coaching, not teaching. Very fresh in a cooperation with the Fraunhofer Institute, we offer coding courses for kids, teachers, parents, grandparents. My motivation was not going to courses Monday morning, 8 o'clock. I typed in YouTube mathematics, and MIT and Stanford were very early with their lectures, all for free on YouTube. And I learned it via YouTube with MIT, with professors who were explaining math in a way I've never seen before. And I said, oh, that could be a thing. I should produce math tutorials on YouTube, but not 1 hour and a half. Cut it down on 5 minutes, now famous for learning nuggets. That's the only thing I can do, and I understand it. It's sports and mathematics. I was always interested in sports and mathematics, and what we learn in school or university is not mathematics, it's calculating, based on the industrial age, where we were thinking, what should our kids learn? Writing, calculating, and mathematics is so much more. It's beautiful, it's understanding things, it's understanding structures, and that's very important in crazy times we are living in with artificial intelligence, machine learning, cloud computing, etc. In shorter times, much more is happening, and you have to deal with it, and with a good fundament of mathematics, you have a well-paid future. I think it's a tipping point, and the majority has not yet understood what this social media thing is in deep. It's marketing for your own brand, for a big brand. It's reaching out a bright mass of people, getting feedback, teaching them, giving them value, and then getting something back in return. Like now you can do those selling stuff. And whether it's YouTube, Facebook, Snapchat, whatever, what Musical.ly, what's next, Vero, a new platform, go in, test, do your stuff, and it will be normal in 5 to 10 years. I mean, what's the definition of an influencer? If you have 10 followers, only 10 followers on Instagram, but you go to a shop and you post, oh, it's so nice here, and two of them will buy something, you are an influencer. I for myself think I'm an influencer for education, because I'm talking to bright mass of people, telling them what you should do, what you should deal with, machine learning, artificial intelligence, etc., etc. The word influencer, I think, will be redefined in the next 2 to 5 years. Like everybody is an influencer, communicating every time, all the time. And there will be micro-influencers, great influencers. For me, I'm fine with calling me education influencer. very careful in terms of education. I mean, I quit university, I'm uncertified, and I'm teaching mathematics, which is for many, many, many students the only thing to pass exams, to go on in the university. I always tell them, look, I have over 100 million views, I have 98% thumbs up rate, it's good. It's the sharing economy, they certified me, and I think more and more people are producing stuff, becoming influencers, and in terms of education we have to do like building some task forces who do a little bit of reglementation, looking for is it right or not, what are you telling the crowd, and we should be careful, and we should bring together those people who really care, who do really good stuff and know what they are doing. It's a real great pain, because mathematics is a pain for everybody. So they are looking, what's the easiest way? It's YouTube, type in math, mathematics. So, and I have so much stuff, so probably you will find me. And obviously I'm doing it quite well, because it's the 5 minutes learning nugget style. It's not the 1 hour and a half a lecture. So if you have a problem, 5 minutes, solved, thank you, no book, no teacher, I'm fine with it, I learned it. We talked about it on stage right now. What do we have to change? I mean, I'm talking to students a lot, and it's always the same. They do not go to lectures, they watch videos, do some meetups, and pass the exam. So it's there, it's good, it's okay, so let's change it. But to talk to teachers, the majority of the teachers, the professors, they are in this standardized system. I am the brain, I know everything, I do that. I don't get it with YouTube and such things. I think the revolution will come from the students, from the crowd. At some point, and it's now pacing up, where everybody is crying out and saying, hey, YouTube does it all for me. There are all my new teacher heroes, whatever, because they do it in a modern way. And so it will crash in the next 5 years. A quick vision could be Spotify for education. In 5 years, you consume all your education stuff via Spotify for Education. And 3 months later, you get a ping on your smartphone. It says, hey, good news. Today, 7 o'clock is your best learning time. We watched out 3 videos for you in terms of artificial intelligence. And you say, wow, happy. Like you're happy now when Spotify gives you the playlist. And you say, how do you do that, Spotify? With artificial intelligence. And by consuming. That would be one vision, be part of a Spotify for Education. Not with YouTube alone, but I build up some startups around it. So I'm selling my learning platform, I'm selling books about mathematics, rewritten in an easy way. I build up some other startups. So to live from YouTube, you have to be like PewDiePie or whatever, with millions and millions of followers. But they also have to do something beside it, like an own shop, build your brand, whatever. YouTube is a gateway to make your own business, but it's not the only one. Somebody is combining it with Facebook marketing, some with Snapchat, some only YouTube, whatever. But you have to go in detail. What will be my business? What I'm using YouTube for? It's a gateway to get a crowd, and then think about what could be your business around it. Document, don't create. I've just talked to a teacher who asked me, what can I do? You have your smartphone in your pocket. Do videos, upload them on YouTube or Facebook. It's the easiest thing, and see what happens. create a niche, whatever, mathematics, UI, UX design, artificial intelligence, and see what happens. Go, do mode, and document what you're doing. Changing the education system.